Okay, so really, for me, the story started about 10 years ago. Like I was, Martin Butler was then my sort of boss. He was a producer of a program called Dateline, an international news and current affairs program on SBS. And he'd sent me to cover a different story, the other side of the island. So you know Isaac Tu, you know the John Frum movement. There had been a split within the community. There was a guy called Prophet Fred who was drawing away followers, and there'd been a bit of a foe, and he said, like, you know, go and cover that story. And so I did, and I was blown away. You know, like, here, you know, just a matter of hours' flight, you know, from Australia, is a place, a tiny island like your island, like 50 kilometres by 20 kilometres, where four languages are spoken. You've got every conceivable tropical environment there. You know, not just the volcano, but, you know, the white sand beaches, black sand beaches, and just like this incredibly rich culture. And because it's a news and current affairs program, like I could only be there for a couple of weeks. And I just remember thinking, oh, I've got to find an excuse to come back, you know, just learn, you know, because it just blew my mind. But it took 10 years to, you know, find that opportunity. And so what I did is once there was a gap, you know, in between our next project. So I said to, first of all, to my wife, Janita, like, you know, would you be interested in doing this? And turned out, you know, she was wanting to quit her job and have a bit of a break. And we had two young children, and we'd always discussed about going to a place that wasn't the suburbs of Melbourne, which is where we're from, to introduce them to different ways of thinking and looking at the world. And somehow use our skills and do something that was collaborative, so that, you know, everyone can, you know, we get something out of it. And so we approached the Culture Centre, and we also spoke to a great anthropologist, Kirk Huffman, who was based in, do you know him?
Yeah, I do. Oh, okay. I've met him recently.
All right.
I spoke to him about the film.
Right, okay. Well, you know, he's you know, a unique individual and a very generous, very knowledgeable person, and both he and the Culture Centre guy from Tanner, who I knew from back then, I said, look, you know, we'd go anywhere in Vanuatu. But not only did they say, oh, you've got to go to Tanner, but you should go to Yakel and ask there first. So that's what we did. In fact, we didn't go anywhere else. We just asked them, we showed them the movie, they watched it and said, can we start tomorrow? And so it was sort of as simple as that. And that sort of can-do, that sort of enthusiasm, that sort of like good feeling was there right from the present, and it continues to this day. So our families stay in contact. They come and stay with us. We've traveled the world together with the film, and you know about what's talked about there in Custom Roads, and you know that idea that you when you set up a road with someone, it's a two-way thing, you know, it's a reciprocal thing, and it's open for life, it's an obligation.